a very critical road because it's the only road that leads to places like Tacloban, Dolores, Borongan, and other provinces and towns hit by Typhoon Ruby. So an engineer from DPWH told me that a lot of relief goods and army trucks weren't able to pass through because of the landslide. But they assure us that by 5 p.m. today, they will be able to clear at least one road so that the trucks can get through.
A long line of military trucks wait for the landslide debris to be cleared. They need to get to Dolores fast. 8th Infantry Division Commander Major General Jed Bellarmino tells Raptor they lost communication with the battalion and don't know the situation in the town where Ruby first made landfall. The Department of Public Works and Highways says they are doing all they can to clear out the choke points.
Tulong-tulong ito. Pero may darating kaming loader. May darating kaming loader on the way. Pagdating ng equipment, hindi namin naiwan ito hanggat hindi open.
Eventually, they are able to clear one lane. But further down the road, a trickier problem arises. Floodwaters on this road reach around 5 feet in some parts. Even the Army 6x6 vehicle may not get through. But this road in Burai is one of only two roads connecting Dolores, Borongan, and Tacloban to northern Samar and Samar. The other road in Barangay Tulay Santa Rita is also flooded and inaccessible. In other parts of Samar, government and citizens help clear large trees. Clearing the roads will make way for relief goods and medical teams sorely needed by affected communities. We will continue to deliver news and updates on Typhoon Ruby's aftermath. Pirenada, Rappler, Yabong, Samar.